Hello students, in this lecture I will discuss about the relief and relief types. What are the types of reliefs? Despite many safety precautions in the chemical plants or chemical processing industries, equipment failures or operator errors can cause increases in the process pressures beyond the safe levels. If pressures rises too high, they may exceed the maximum strength of pipelines or vessels. This can result in the rupturing of process equipments, causing major release of toxic materials or toxic chemicals. Here we can see from figure. This figure shows the methods used for the safe installation of pressure relief device. According to this, the first step in the procedure is to specify where relief devices must be installed. Means the first step is to installation of the relief devices. And second one is the appropriate relief device type must be selected. The type depends mostly on the nature of material relieved and the relief characteristic required. And third, scenarios are developed that describe the various ways in which a relief can occur. The motivation is to determine the material mass flow rate. You know about the mass flow rate, the material mass flow rate through the relief and the physical state of the materials. The physical state of materials means like liquid, vapor or two phases. And the last one is the data are collected on the relief process, including the physical properties of the ejected materials and the relief is sized. Finally, the worst case scenario is selected and the final relief design is achieved. So this is the basic methods used for the safe installation of pressure relief devices. Next is the relief concepts. What is the concept of reliefs? Here there are some following reasons which may require the pressure relief system. First one is the to protect personnel from the dangers of overpressurizing equipment. Second, to minimize chemical losses during pressure upsets. To prevent damage to equipment. To prevent damage to adjoining property. To produce insurance premiums and to comply with governmental regulations. So these are the basic concept of the relief. Now the next one is the this is the pressure versus time graph for runway reactions. As you can see from figure, firstly I will tell you what is the runway reactions. Suppose that an exothermic reaction is occurring in the reactor. Suppose that you have a reactor and in which the exothermic reaction is occurring. Then the temperature of reactor rises when the cooling is lost due to some reasons such as loss of cooling water supply, failure of valve or other reasons. As the temperature increases, the rate of reactions increases, leading to an increase in heat production. This self-accelerating mechanism results in a runway reactions. So this is the runway reactions. The runway reactions for large commercial reactors may take place within a minute, with temperature and pressure increases of several hundred degrees per minute and several hundred psi per minute respectively. Temperature increases with the several hundred degrees per minute and pressure increases with the several hundred psi per minute. Here in this curve, the cooling is lost at time t equal to 0. Now I will tell you from the figure there are two cases. Suppose that in the first case, if the reactor has no relief system, the pressure and temperature continue to rise until the reactants in the reactor are completely consumed, as shown in figure C, closed reactor. After the consumption of reactants, the heat generation stops and the reactor cools. The pressure subsequently drops. From the figure, curve C, assume that the reactor is capable of withstanding of full pressure of the runaway reactions. As I have already told you that what is the runaway reactions. This is the first one case, if the reactor has no relief system. In the second case, suppose that if the reactor has relief device, the pressure response is dependent upon the relief device characteristics and the properties of fluid discharged through the relief. This is illustrated by curve A, as shown in figure, for vapor relief only, and curve B for two-phase froth. Two-phase froth means vapor and liquid. When the froth is discharged in curve B, as shown in figure, the pressure continues to rise as the relief valve opens. The incremental pressure increases over the initial relief pressure.